Greetings and welcome to LGR Plays, and this is DCS, Digital Combat Series World, a sort of self-contained little world of DCS products, and it's by Eagle Dynamics, and if you're not familiar with them, well, they did the Lock-On series a little while back, and then also the more popular ones recently were like the A-10 and the CA-50 helicopter thing. Those are on Steam. What was it, Black Shark? I had those at one point, or at least I had this one. I had the first one, then this is the second one, and then, yeah, A-10, I don't think I ever had that one. I always wanted it, but anyway, then they came out with this P-51D, and then they came out with this DCS World thing. Well, DCS World, this is completely free. This is like a self-contained combat thing, so you can do campaigns and missions, and it comes with the Su-25T Frogfoot plane. You can fly that around and do all sorts of coolness. It's not quite as detailed as the ones you pay for. You have these paid modules you can add on to it. Like I got the P-51 because I've wanted that for a while. So let's go ahead and just take a look at this. So we got the P-51. We're going to go with that one for now. Let's go into pick my country. I'm going to go with the UK. We're going to start from the ramp because I want to see if I can start it up. Yeah, right. It's not going to happen. And let's do 11 a.m. because that's the time of day. Now let's just go into here. I don't give a crap. We're going to generate a mission. Now, it has a bunch of missions you can do already, or you can just generate your own like this. And this is just sort of a quick way to just jump in and play stuff. Or if you want to, you can go super friggin' in-depth, edit your own missions. And there's a lot to do. I mean, this is crazy involved. I haven't even begun to look at the depth of this simulation. It's awesome. But let's take a look at where I am. I forget how big it is. It's like hundreds and hundreds of kilometers square that you can actually fly around in and do other things with. In fact, there's even a ground unit expansion or module, which isn't, it's not too in-depth. It's not as in-depth as like the flight stuff from what I gather, but it's still pretty cool. Anyway, so I've got what should be my plane if I can click on it. What am I doing? There it is. Okay, so I'm the P-51, and we're going to edit my livery here. Actually, bare metal sounds good, but I'm going to go with the 112 Squadron. Yes, so let's do this. You can change your loadout and everything here. Dude, like, so many freaking options. There's just options, man. Options. And, of course, you can make all sorts of units be in the game here. I mean, there's naval units, there's ground units, there's helicopters, there's jets, there's infantry. Yeah, you can go all out, but we're just going to fly a plane. Nope. I apologize in advance to anyone that actually knows what they're doing here. I clearly don't, but I think that has some entertainment value. This is certainly not meant to be educational whatsoever. Okay, now what we're going to do here is completely ignore what I'm supposed to do. That is the combat crap or whatever. I don't know. We'll try to. But what I'm going to do is just get the plane started. And if you saw my video I did on Flight Simulator X, the A2A simulations Spitfire, where I tried to start that without knowing how to, you might know a bit of what to expect for the next few minutes. I don't know what the frick I'm doing. Although I do know a little bit more since then, but all I've done so far is play with this plane with just the auto start, or like already on the runway and taken off, but actually starting it from just a cold start, I don't know what I'm doing. So let's try this out. In fact, let's look around first, because it looks cool. That's a nice looking plane. I like me some World War II fighter planes. So, let's get inside the plane, because out here isn't going to help with the cockpit whatsoever. Alright, so, much like that Spitfire, everything can be done from inside here. You just, do it with a mouse, you do things, you play around, and hopefully do things right. I have an Xbox 360 stick here, which is doing this. The stick on the pad. I really need a proper joystick and throttle and all that crap. As many flight sims as I play, but whatever, that's neither here nor there. So what the frick am I doing? Well, No idea. None whatsoever. Let's do this. Let's... Here's a nice big red thing. Let's do that. Well, that's a good sign. Ah! Where did it go? Oh, it's down there. Whoops. Okay, that didn't work. Sorry. I know kind of where to start, though. There should be a battery in here somewhere. Battery... Is it over here? No, radiator. North American Aviation. I love the detail in here, though. It's just, it's awesome. Even though I don't know what I'm looking at. Can I unzip that? Nope. Cannot unzip the plane's pants. That's too bad. Well... Maybe circuit breaker. Ah, frick. I'm probably looking right at it. What does that do? Nope, nothing. Does that do anything? Nope. There's a bell. Is that a bell? Ding, ding. Service, please. I need help. Recon lights? That's cool. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Oh, come on. It's got to be in here. This so looks like it. Okay, well then, screw the battery. Let's just see if we can find... I know we need that. Okay, so there's fuel around here somewhere. Here we go. Fuel shut off. I need that on because I need fuel. Well, that's one thing. I got fuel, guys. Want anything else? Nope, probably not. Circuit protectors. Push to... That doesn't do anything. Crap. Okay, so these are lights. Ah, that sounds good. Let's turn them all on. No idea. No idea whatsoever. Nope. Lights or something? Oh, I turned it off, whatever it was. Jeez. Oh, no! Turn that off. I don't want to hear that. You hear me not knowing what I'm doing. Get him off the runway. Dang it, man. Let's just turn these on. I don't know what the frick that is. Over here. It's all on. Danger. Wow. So I'm pretty amazing. I know that. Let's just trust that that did something then. All right. So I got maybe power. And what? Fuel? I got that on. Seems like there's something else, though. What am I missing here? What does this do? Droppable fuel tanks released by using bomb salvo. Well, I don't know how I do that, then. Is this... Nope. That doesn't do anything. Well, this is fantastic. Ooh, this looks fun up here. What is this? Cockpit lights? Oh, I'll turn those on. Yeah, got some lights. I needed some of those. I was working in the dark here. Oh, this looks good. Booster. See? There's a sound. Primer. Sure. Oh, we're getting somewhere here. Oil? No, I don't need to delete that crap. Supercharger. Oh, that sounds good. High blower on. Push to test. I don't know. Let's see. Yeah, need all the lights we can so they can see, people can see their doom coming. What is that? Flaps. Oh, well. We'll deal with those later. Carburetor. That sounds important. Let's put it up there. No idea about that. Warm air control. Yeah, warm sounds good for starting. Frick. Ah, I have no idea. Let's just hit the starter. Where the frick is that? Ah, oh, good grief. Is it back there? Nope. Ah, man, there's so many things. And this is a simple plane, relatively. Oxygen regulator. Why would I need that? Yeah, I'm gonna press it. Screw that. Alright. Ah! Well, school's out. I can go home. Press the wrong button! What happened? Oh my! Oh no! Well. What? Man, oh, now I'm in a raging inferno. I gotta start this plane up. Okay, what do I do? What do I do? Okay, let's hurry. I'm gonna burn down. Okay, let's just put all this crap back. Oh, let's see, I did that. I might not want to do everything I did, because obviously that didn't work. Switch all these things, press that, frick, I don't know. Here's the thing. Press that thing. Don't press that thing, because that was not good. I don't even know. Where the frick is the ignition? That's all I want to know here. Okay, supercharger. That's fine. Oh, ignition. There it is. Ah. Both. Oil booster primer is important, I think. I know it is. Let's trust it's good. Guns. That sounds nice. Oh, did the fire go out? Oh, thank goodness. Okay. Let's try this. Here it is. Huh? Yeah! Doesn't sound good, but... Oh, no. Well, at least it didn't blow up that time. Daggone it. Jeez. Let's try that one more time. Actually, I probably need fuel, though. Yeah, let's do that. Let's see what that does. Give it more! Come on! Work! Pile of junk. Come on, all this is right, right? Maybe that's... No. Flaps, that thing, landing lights, need those. In case it blows up again. Try one more time. Farts! Okay, I hear a sound. My word. What did I do? Fuel's on, isn't it? Pretty sure it's on. Ah, crap. Okay, well, I'm gonna cheat. Let's just start it up, because I know there's a button to do that. There we go. Yeah, here we go. I have no idea what it did. What is it doing? My plane is working on its own. Oh, it's telling me what it's doing up there. Yeah, that's right. So, flap handle. Oh, I did have to do something with the flat. Oh, parking brake, that would have been nice. Increase propeller RPM. Oh, man, I missed a bunch of steps, didn't I? Okay, you just... Oh, don't tell me you can't start it either. Computer's like, what have you done to this thing? It's all screwed up in here. Alright. Huh?
Infield 1, you're from the west.
Whoa.
Engaging the utility at bullseye 069 for 17.
Yeah, I got a mirror. See behind me now. What is that back there? Aircraft is ready to fly. Well, if you say so.
Chevy 1, field artillery at bullseye 060 for 14.
Yeah, I don't think it's ready to fly, man. It's not flying. I don't see any flight happening here. Aw. Well then. Jeez. This is fantastic. I thought I would have had it. Because I messed with another Mustang on FSX and kind of got it once. But this one's a lot more involved. I think that was a B Mustang. It was a little different than this one anyway. Ah, crap. No, that's good. Start! Oh, I'm so screwed. Let's just do all these things. Ah! Home! Wow, that found a guns!
Infield 1, you're from the west, engaging the utility at bullseye 074 for 19.
And I hope nothing's on its way here. I am a sitting Mustang. It's not good. Why can't I take off? If the auto start isn't doing anything. Start!
Chevy 1, wind from the southwest, engaging utility at bullseye 069 for 17.
Nutsack.
Hog 1, in from the west, engaging utility at bullseye 069
Rockets.
For 17. Infield 1, kill utility at bulls 074 for 19.
Oh, hey. Here's something. That's what I thought. Well, now we can take this thing off. I'd be ready to go.
Infield 1, you're from the east, engaging the utility at
bulls. Let's just reset it and see what we get.
For 17.
Alright, yeah, that's good. It's good right there. Yeah, we got this. Now, let's get out of the rubble of failures past. Let's see, Ah, crap. That's throttle! Yeah! Found the rudders. Oh my. Hey, what? No! Stop turning! Ah! Oh, come on! Let's try that again. I'm gonna take control of this here plane, see? Ah, here we go. Now, should just be able to, Nope, not that way. No, too much! No, not again! Ah, we're fine, we just lost a flap. Oh, we're about to lose more than that. Okay, I could have sworn everything was okay. Ah. I should just stay in the interior view here. Okay, that's great, because now I can't see where I'm going. Well, I'll just trust I'm okay and we'll take off. Take off! Take off! Oh my god! Oh no! What the heck is with this thing? These aren't easy to fly. Oh, that poor thing. It does not deserve this. Set myself up on the runway here, so, yes. See if this works. I've got to be able to at least take off. This is ridiculous. Stay on the runway! Yep. Oh no. This kills the plane. It's gonna keep going. Sad. Okay, now I'm really, really, really seriously. This is gonna get off the ground, and it's gonna stay off the ground, like, you know, up in the air. Oh yeah. I got enough runway here. This can happen. It's not impossible. It's just, holy crap, this must be windy as balls or something. Good grief, seriously. I'm not sucking that bad. I can't be that bad. I've taken this thing off before, and it wasn't this bad. Ugh. Alright, that's, sort of. Okay. Okay. You know, I would just let it fly wherever it blows me, but that's no fun. Let's try to land it without gear. That worked exactly how I expected. Oh! Well, even better. Man. Yeah, I love simulations. I just love, treating them how you're not supposed to. That's wonderful, really. Yeah, screw going straight. I don't know what happens if we hit this. Well, that's to be expected. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and give it one more go here in the free plane that DCS World comes with, the Frogfoot. And as you can see from the cockpit here, it's not quite as detailed, but still pretty friggin' detailed. You can't click the cockpit or anything, so I'm just going to go into the external view and see what happens when I inevitably crash. Oh yeah, afterburners, baby! Danger zone. Wow, it kind of runs terribly here. All right, let's see what we get. Oh yeah, I can kind of take this thing off. I'm a jet. Yeah, flying is nice. Flying is good. Especially when you're not exploding for no frickin' reason, or getting flung around in turbulence, or having your life ended by school bells in the cockpit. Yes, flying. It's good. Especially in Soviet equipment. Yeah, man, I like it, man. You got the special delivery, man! Russian plane. Oh no! Not exactly an unexpected result.
Meanwhile, in Apache territory, nobody gives a crap. Especially since it's not an Apache, that's a Havoc.
Yep, well, that's pretty much it. That's DCS World. It's a heck of a lot more involved than I'm showing here, but you can crash planes spectacularly. And if you get the paid-for planes, you know, $40 to screw around in a Mustang, yeah, it's probably a bit much. But for me, well, I just wanted it. And so I got it. And it's awesome.
And this takeoff is going too well. Let's screw it up.
Let's go out with a bang.
Meanwhile, in Havoc territory, they still don't give a crap. Especially since he keeps crashing his planes repetitiously.
LGR Plays, thanks for watching and allowing me to waste your time.